Hello, gamer guys and gamer gals. This is John Arnhem, the Indie Detective, and I'm coming with you on a little journey. A journey through the ages of industry. Today we're going to be doing a little Let's Play of Rise of Industry, the new name for what was originally called Project Automata. The entire point of this game is to create little cities of industry that will churn out products for you to sell across a randomly generated map. Alright, cool. Apply. We're going to go do a quick start game. It just randomly throws us onto a procedurally generated map. Here we are in our new land of industry. I'm going to go ahead and put it on pause here real quick. I just wasted a couple, two, 3 days. Use WASD to get around. If you hold shift, you will quickly jet around the map back. So there are a couple things you need to know about every town. This is nice. They just added this in the newest patch where everything is filled in. They used to have little placeholder buildings that were just grayed out. So the grocery store is where you will sell your first products. It's all just agriculture. And you need to build up your industry in order to do the more expensive things. You can obviously just sell straight apples if you want to, but you want to be selling the more expensive things like juice and hamburgers. Water is one of the most important resources. You can only get it by building water siphons on the coast, and that means that coastal cities are quite useful. Pasadena here, let me see. So we can sell the meat directly from a farm, or we can take the time to produce hamburgers. Of course, you need to really work on your production capacity and how efficient your production line is, because every building has an upkeep. So you need to make sure that you're covering your upkeep when you're selling your products. How many towns in total do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six towns total. Ooh, and this is a beautiful little coastal town here in Peking. And they want fish and canned fish, which I can just get right off the bat, and fruit stuff, fruit juice, which I can build slightly inland. So if I just make a couple of water siphons, I can get us started. All right, well, let's get started with our industry. We need to start off with a water siphon. We need to be placed on the coast in a flat coast spot, which this is a bit of a pain. Oh, there we go. Ah, perfect. And every single harvester needs these little side doodads. They changed those around too. They used to be two side to side. And now I guess they go back and forth. So that's awesome. You can fit more in side by side. Everything needs to be connected by road, obviously. So I'm going to go ahead and build a road out of the plant. It goes right into downtown Peking. When you do have an extra factory that you need to ship the water to, this is how you will do it. You will select the building that it goes to, although obviously we don't have anything right now. So yeah, we'll get started on that shortly. Peking will buy fish from me, so I'm just going to go ahead and, there it is, Fisherman's Pier. And this one, I believe, hangs off into the water a little bit, so it does need to be built at least on a corner piece. Go ahead and build that Fisherman's Pier. Now the harvester, these harvesters, will take the goods from that they harvest out in the ocean, take them back to the main plant, and then you will have the trucks transport them to their final destination. So this place, I can go to commercial. There's a grocery store right here in Peking, a mere 20 tiles away. I can set it to go there and start selling fish. You just need to assign a series of trucks. And we're good to go. This is not to sell the product, this is to buy and sell trucks. Do not accidentally click that, you will lose trucks, and I believe you only get back half as much as you would originally be spending. So now we can see each one of our boats is going out and catching fish. It will tally up our store here. This is how much you have in storage. And then it will send it to the grocery store in Peking. Alright, so now that we're done with that, we're going to want to start working on some finished products. I want to start working on some canned fish. Now, like I said, that means that we need to have some coal. That's oil, that's not coal. gosh, we just have so much iron ore here. There's not a lot of coal around. Like I said, I think Amsterdam's gonna be the place. So, I think we're gonna go ahead and build a train terminal. We wanna go in that way so that our road can connect right to the main highway. And we're gonna just take the train rail. All right, now we can grab this rail, go from terminal A all the way to terminal B. No path can be found. Don't you give me that, I just saw it. There we go. There's gold there for half a second. Oh, alpha titles. Oh boy! There goes all that money. Gosh, look at those millions just chugging away. Boom! Connected! Hey, perfecto! Look at that. Now it goes straight through. I thought those were little end terminals, but they're not. Neat. So now, I can start setting this up to build my steel cans, which I need to first extract. So I'll have a coal mine. The radius around there shows where it can extract coal from. And there, that's the limit that you can place your harvesters in. So I'm gonna put that there. And we're gonna build our harvesters. Iron up here. I think this might be the better place. And then I can just set up the cannery, the can producing can producing place right over here. All right. That looks good. Let's do it. Harvesters. All right. So, I think this is where I'm going to build the foundry. So we need a glassworks and smelter. This is what turns the coal and iron into steel. This one building does a variety of tasks. That's actually how most things work in this game. Every building does a variety of things. So here, we're going to want steel sheets. So it takes, it takes two iron ore and a coal. Maybe that other iron mine would be actually useful. Because I'm gonna need to double down on iron production. Or I can just build more harvesters. That's always an option too. All right, so we need to send things to the foundry. So we will go to factories, the glassworks and smelter, and we'll send a couple of trucks over there. And we're gonna need to do the same thing with the iron mine. To the factories, set iron ore. But I think we're gonna need all the trucks we can get shipping iron ore over there. In fact, I'm gonna get more harvesters. More harvesters. This one's gonna need to go all the way back around the back of the factory. It won't be super efficient, but I need more harvesters. Yeah, actually quite inefficient if you ask me, but now we'll get them to work. Let's go ahead and this can just be our juice producing area over here. Let's go ahead and make a food factory. It'll tell me everything that I need in order to produce the juice. So if I go to production, juice. I need glass bottles, fruit, and water. It didn't used to need water. You just squeeze the juice right in there. I guess now we're gonna need an extra water siphon. It will start pumping water. So now this one's been going for a while, so he already has a nice little store built up there. Every single time they get a unit of water, the trucks from the harvesters bring it to the main plant. Here we see, this is all the fish coming into the grocery. There's our money. Ching, ching, ka-ching. And because we have three trucks and there's four harvesters doing their work, the trucks take longer than the harvesters, it looks like. So we're building up a good little store, and we will keep building that. All right, back to the juice. So we're going to have enough water coming in. Then we're going to need the fruit. So we're going to need to build an orchard. Orchards are interesting little buildings. Same with all of the different farms. I thought I turned off Discord. Oh well, I'm just going to keep going. You guys can deal with it. When you're doing production, let me see, we want orange fields, because that's what makes our fruit. You just get these extra fields here, and they have to be built in proximity to the orchard itself. So I'm just going to build them off to the side here. They can be built in proximity to each other as well. And I'll just keep going back, because I'm not worried about that forest right now. Eventually I'll want to start building some lumber mills, because, you know, beer goes in barrels, so does whiskey. Those are excellent things. And we need lots of water coming in here. Fortunately, we have a water siphon right nearby that's got a excellent store built up right now. So let's go ahead and send it to the farm. We're going to go ahead and just use all the trucks for now because they're not doing anything else. They will automatically start loading up. Oh, interesting. I think that must be another new thing. I think we're like paying wages or something there for the truckers. So the trucks go in, they deliver the water to the orchard. You can see the store being built up there, and as soon as it has its two water, a field gets watered and it starts producing. Production takes a little while. In fact, I might just... here we go. Get all that water delivered. Now, the other thing that we need for this food factory is glass. Glass is pretty simple to make, but it takes a lot of space to harvest the sand from. So we're going to need a sand collector. They get built on the coast as well, I believe. Must be built on non-blocked coast tiles. Ah, there we go. I think they need to be built side onto the non-blocked coast tiles. That's what it looks like anyway. Perfect, because I don't like corner tiles, so if I can get rid of them with a nice thing like that, that works great for me. Here's one of the little collectors. I'm just going to build a bunch of these things because we're going to need a lot of sand for glass. Start harvesting sand. The production rate's pretty good. Pretty good. Oop. Like I said, you got to keep an eye out for these non-linked roads. They happen sometimes. Oh yeah, look at that water just pouring onto those fields. He's going to develop a nice little backlog of water here. And we'll get those oranges growing. And we can just send them right over to the... right over to that food factory. Because he's going to be making our juices. Now, like I said, we do need a little bit of water going to that food factory too. So I'm just going to take two of those trucks that we're delivering to the farm. Now it's got a little store of water. I'm going to take two of them and start storing up in that food factory too. Oh, see, there is the upkeep ding. That took quite a bit of money, it looked like. Let me pause real quick. Total expenses, vehicle purchases, vehicle upkeep, building upkeep. Ah, there it is. This is last month. So here is this month. I just spent $60,000 on building upkeep. That's not terrible. Vehicle upkeep cost me more, but, you know, here is what I spent on all that rail, on all the buildings and everything. I spent $10 million, 20% of our total budget last month. This month, looks like all we've done is build sand. Alright, so we've got... ooh, that stocked up fast. See, like I said, it doesn't automatically add it to the stockpile. What happened is all of those things finished producing. They loaded a unit onto the truck. And now it's taking it to the sand collector, to the main hub. And load it up into all those nice little silos. So what we need to do, we're going to build another one of these buildings. This is the same one that's making all that steel up there in Amsterdam for us. But this time, it's going to make glass. Needs three sand to make one glass pane. So it also will be the same building that makes our bottles. So they'll take the one glass pane, turn it into one glass bottle, and we'll ship it over to the juice factory. So let's take all of our trucks. Yep, all of our trucks, and go to a factory, and it's the Peking Glassworks and Smelter. Have 3 trucks available, 3 trucks moving. And they'll automatically load up, ching, ching, ching. Paying the wages of the dudes running forklifts and whatnot. Over here, we're gonna select the food factory. Oh, right, no, because we're making glass. Glass would not do much for a food factory, because we need to make it into bottles first. By building another factory. Glassworks and Smelter. There we go. And see, he just took his sheet of glass, turned it into a bottle. It will now be loaded onto a truck and sent over to the food factory, which has everything else that it needs to make our first unit of juice. This is how Rise of Industry works. Boom. Got everything he needed. Loaded into the production line. And now it's churning out juice. And then we have everything we need to ship juice to Peking. And it will go to the grocery store and start making profit for us. 14,970 per unit. Much better than the 975 we're getting per unit of fish. Which, right now, that's all that this fishing pier is doing. Oh, so an interesting thing happened. Now that we've been selling things to Peking, the town's growing. There's a crop farm here now. And he built these crop fields. Now, you might have noticed there's an extra building in every town. It's this wholesaler. And they sell the other products that the town makes. So, for instance, if I wanted to build a livestock farm, you need to feed something to the livestock, which is wheat. So I can now buy wheat from this third-party farm that is sold through the wholesaler, and then feed that to my cattle and make steaks and hamburgers out of it, which then I can sell for my own profit. Our water siphon is churning away, delivering water where it's needed. We've got enough glass and oranges and water to just keep churning out juice. This is fantastic. All right, so yeah, our juice production line is running. Boom. Right there, that was our first sale of juice to the grocery store. All right, so the train terminal's here. Oh my gosh, can you imagine how much... Ah, we've got so much steel. All right, well, it's about time that we start thinking about that canned fish, huh? So we've got this, let me see. Amsterdam steel. Not the graphics card, obviously. All right. So, we've got the steel being made. We need another smelter to turn it into cans. Now what I'm going to need these guys to do is to send their tin cans to the train station. Right? Because we're going to need to ship everything that we make in Amsterdam down to Peking. And then we can take the fish and the cans, open another food factory. There it is. And this will be the canned fish factory. Man, Peking's gonna grow real fast once we start selling both canned fish and juice to them. Man, doesn't that sound like a great lunch? Canned fish and juice. Oh, that actually sounds really terrible. Anyway, I'm going to make a little cut here. This will be the end of this video. And yeah, come back for another episode of Rise of Industries gameplay, and we'll get another industry rolling. Sounds good to you? I'll get the train come down here, we'll get the canned fish made, and we'll start selling that to Peking, and then we'll start developing some of our other towns. Thanks for watching the video, gamer guys and gamer gals. This has been John Arnhem, your Indie Detective, with another gameplay episode of the Indie Detectives Review Series. All right, take care, everyone. Bye.